Hello everyone and welcome to today's video. For today's video, I'm going to be doing eye swatches with this beautiful palette from Adept Cosmetics. This is their new Seahorse palette. So if you are interested on hearing my thoughts on this palette, then please stick around for today's video. So honestly guys, I wanted this palette for so long, ever since they have sneak peeked this beautiful seahorse packaging. Like, even before they had the concept of like two seahorses, I wanted it from the very beginning, even before I saw the color story. And then they launched the price and I was like, $140, huh? No, can't do it. I can't do it. So I had no intentions of even buying this palette because it was so like unrealistic for my like price range, if you will. But they recently did like early access launch. You can sign up for their emails and you get notified. So they did like a early launch for this and I think it was like 20% off, free shipping, all of that good stuff. So this ended up being, I think it was like $113 for me. So that was a little bit more justifiable or whatever. This was actually my Mother's Day gift from my husband. So I'm very excited that I was actually able to get this because I didn't think I was actually going to be able to, because just at that $140, I was like, you gotta draw the line somewhere, you know? So this is what the beautiful palette looks like. I'm going to pop up like pictures, swatches, all of that. But initially, whenever I realized I was actually able to get this palette, and once it got to me, I was trying to think about how do I go about showing you just how beautiful this palette is. And I really thought that eye swatches would be the best way that I can show you exactly how each shade looks, because realistically you could just go in with any eyeshadow palette, use your favorite mattes, and put one of these beautiful shimmers on top. So I thought that my review would be helpful in a way of just showing you each shadow on my eye. So that's what I'm gonna do today, just so I can show you how beautiful and sparkly and shifty these actually are. So if that sounds interesting to you, then please make sure you are subscribed to my channel, because I do lots, oh my god, I almost dropped this palette. I would have lost my mind. I do lots of eye swatch videos and like low light videos to where you can see like the true swatches, let's see, the shiftiness, sparkliness of all the shadows. So make sure you're subscribed to my channel. I do have a code with Adept Cosmetics. It's BRITTANYRAE. Now if they do like a bigger discount, I will make sure to let you know, but I think that my discount will save you 10% off, but definitely make sure you can get the biggest discount. But let's get this baby on my eyes. I feel a little rusty. I have not filmed in quite some time. I had my baby girl, so I have a newborn and I also have a toddler. They're both taking a nap and I was like, holy moly, it is time to film. I got both of these palettes in the mail. Like, what a good mail day. Anyway, so I was super excited that I have kind of like a little bit of time to film. So we're just going to get into it. I'm just going to kind of go down this way like this, if you're curious in what order I'm swatching them. I figured that that would be kind of like, I don't know, that makes sense to me. So sorry if I'm rusty, because it's just been a little while since I've filmed. I'm definitely pre-filmed for all of May and into June even. So I'm gonna first go in with the shade Courtship on one of my eyes. They're so shifty, man. They're so pretty. I was not expecting just how pretty these were. Okay, so this is a very smooth texture. It's like an icy blue. It shifts till I see green, I see gold. Wow, this is definitely, I mean, they're all gonna be special. Adept Cosmetics, I don't know where, but I saw that they said that an all shimmer palette was their most requested palette from them, that everyone's been requesting a full palette of just beautiful multi-chrome special shades with no mattes. And with that, the price obviously will be jumped up, which we saw with this. I personally would have preferred to see like the Aero palette, the La Cienega palette, a row of mattes, just so we could keep the price point down. But you know, maybe that all the customers that did request this palette, maybe this will kind of like suffice that craving of an all shimmer palette, and then we can going forward have some with mattes, so the price point will be more attainable in a way. Not too many people can just drop that much money on a palette, you know? Okay, so I'm gonna turn down the brightness in just a minute. And next I'm gonna do a big belly on the other eye right here. And let's see, this one is not as textured as Courtship, but it's still smooth. This one's, it kind of seems like a little bit lackluster just whenever I fill it. It's more dry. Normally with Adept, typically, like, they have more, like, I don't know, wet in a way. But I'm just going to put this one on. This one looks very similar. Yeah, I don't know if this one's my favorite. It's kind of dry. I'm trying to think back of all my Adept palettes. I don't know if I've ever seen a shadow that felt like this. Okay, so I just turned on the brightness and you can kind of see the sparkle more. Honestly, they look really, I don't know, similar to me. That's the one reason why I wanted to do the eye swatches, because I couldn't really tell a big difference in the swatches, like, on Adept's Instagram. They all just looked really light and kind of similar in a way. But yeah, this one's more intense. This one's a little bit more toned down. But yeah, I definitely prefer this one. This one has more teal versus this one. This one kind of reminds me of, like, cotton candy, like, with the blue and the pink. And then this one's kind of more, like, mermaid with the teal, the gold, all of those pretty shades. So I'm going to wash this off and we'll be back to do two more. My makeup's probably going to look a hot mess, but that's okay. I really don't care because I just want to show you the prettiness of the eyeshadows. Next, I'm going to go in with the shade Tiger Tail right here. Oh, it's really pretty. Let's see. This one. Okay, this one feels nice. Alright, very smooth. Oh, gosh, why do I keep almost... Fun fact, I have dropped every single one of my Adept palettes and none of them have broke. Yeah, none of them have broke, but I just don't want to drop this one. Okay, so this one has more purple, whereas those other two had more blueness to them. So let's pop this one on. Okay, this is like purple with green and gold shifts to it. Very, very pretty shade. Oh, if y'all know of Xenon from Give Me Glow, this is like that shade, but not as much like flakiness, texture. It doesn't enhance like the wrinkles on your lids. This would be like more of a subdued version of Xenon. That's just kind of like my initial impressions of this one. Now I want to go on the shade Giraffe. Oh, yeah, this one's like purple, blue, green, gold shifting. Okay, so now we're gonna go with Giraffe, and this one just looks like it's gonna be a little bit more creamy. Yes, so this is like my favorite texture from them. It's kind of like, I don't know, squishy in a way, more flakiness, that kind of thing, just more intense, if you will. Holy moly. And I'm not I don't have any NYX glitter glue on. Okay, so honestly guys, I take that back. This is I might have got too much. This is a little bit too flaky. Like, look at that. Oh, my lids look terrible. So definitely go in. If you have this palette and you are going in with the shade Giraffe, maybe, like, don't go in as much as me. It's definitely enhancing my texture. Okay. So this one is very similar to Tiger Tail, but it has more, I want to say, like, silver in there. I'm gonna turn on the brightness now. Okay, so right off the bat, do you see how more intense this shade is because of that texture difference? Whereas this one's more smooth. Wow, look at that purple. These are so pretty. Whereas this one has more of like a deeper base. Very, very pretty shadows. And the sparkle, that's on another level. Definitely, I'm intrigued to see that there's definitely some different formulations. You get lots of different textures within this one palette. So, I don't know. I'm excited to see it. The last one on the first row is Low Crown. And this one is... Okay, so this one feels like it has the same formulation as the Big Belly. It's more dry. So, I'm not used to seeing that from Adept. But this one, I think it's going to be more flattering if you have textured lids. Because it's not, like, wet. So, if you don't like a wet shadow, then, hey, maybe this one is for you. Okay, I love, just right off the bat, this beautiful, almost peachy sheen it has. I'm gonna have to turn down the brightness to really see. They all look kind of pastel in like everyday light, but once you turn on the brightness, you can kind of see them better. But this one, it's like purple with lots of different gold peachy reflex in there. And then I want to go, I don't know how to say this, what in the world, I don't know, look, this shade right here, let's let it focus. Focus. Okay, this one, that's what I'm gonna go on next. It's blue. Let's see. Oh, lots of pretty reflex in this one as well. Okay, This one's kind of like that drier formula. When I say dry, I don't mean that in a bad way. I just mean not, if you're familiar with Adept, I'm saying dry because they're not that super wet, intense, squishy like House of L or like the Heather Austin, the Minka. You know what I'm saying. Those are like that wet, squishy and super impactful. Whereas I have noticed that these are more dry. The Arrow palette, those are very smooth. So I've just noticed different textures from them. This shade kind of reminds me of like the packaging, like the purple with almost like that gold peachy yellow reflex. And this blue just, it makes me think of the sea. It's very pretty. Blue with purple pink reflex in there. Super, super pretty. A very wearable blue in a way. I feel like this whole palette, it's kind of like that pastel iridescent jewel gem vibes, you know, like I don't know, just very wearable color shade. So I'm gonna rinse this off and I'll be back with two more. Okay, so now I'm gonna go in with this other blue. See how like they look kind of similar? That's why I wanted to do these eye swatches, so we could see together the difference. And same thing, that more dry formula. And we're just gonna pop that on. So this blue, wow, this one's pretty. It doesn't have like those pink reflex in there. It's like a blue purple. Let's see, almost like those violet pops, really pretty. Just I don't know, I don't know if I'm digging this drier formula. Okay, next I'm gonna go, TYRO, this shade, like the swirly one. It pains me to mess this up. Like I really don't want to, but I'm gonna have to. Let's just like have its time, one last moment before I ruin it with my fingers. I'm so curious at what color this is gonna bring us. Oh, it's pretty. It's like a kind of super wearable. I wasn't expecting that. Okay, so this is almost like a champagne-esque like multi-chrome with all the beautiful sparkles in there, like all the different shades, but it pulls very neutral, like everyday wearable with like pink and blue and yellow sparkles. So I'm a little underwhelmed with, you know, this is just the first impressions. But yeah, I don't know. Okay, this shade is so, so pretty. I just love how the base is so wearable, like almost champagne pinky leaning, and you have all the beautiful sparkles in there. It's so, so pretty. And then this one, it's more of like a, ultraviolet blue purple. Super, super pretty. So we are halfway done with the swatches, and I'm just going to add a little bit of concealer onto my lids and blend this out so the shadows can like have something to kind of stick to, and that way it just kind of helps everything apply nicely. Now I'm going in with the shade False Eye, and this shade, it just looks like that aquamarine baby blue in the pan. It looks so, so pretty. Okay, so I'm definitely just going to layer this one everywhere. It's almost like a diamond, if a diamond was a multi-chrome. Wow. This would be so beautiful, like a pop in the inner corner. So yeah, this is like an iridescent baby blue with green, like mint shimmers almost. Very, very pretty. But this is almost like a diamond for me. Wow. Okay. Very pretty. Now I'm really excited about this one. This is a shade Narrow Bellied. I don't know, it's green with gold, so y'all know I love green, so this one I'm very intrigued to see what this one looks like. And yeah, oh, this baby picks up on your finger, like really intense lime shade it looks like. Wow. Okay, this one has definitely more impact than the past few we have swatched. Really, really pretty. And here are those two shades, kind of with this low lighting, all the sparkle. I really like this green, and I love this shade. It's just like a diamond in a way. I don't know. These two are really, really pretty in my opinion. And I do like how they're a little different. They're not like the blues, the pinks, and the purples. I like that they added these in here. Okay, we are on the last row, and the last row is honestly what I'm most excited about. Oh, I cannot wait. Okay, so let's see. Long Snout. It's like orange, pink, gold. This one looks so, so nice. I'm a sucker for these kind of warm-toned multi-chromes. So let's just dive in. Oh, this one's extra smooth. I really like this one. Like this texture. It's dry. Kind of like the, I don't know, common theme of this palette. But this one's a little bit extra smooth. Kind of like the Aero palette. Those are just like, whoa, those are next level smooth. And silky. Okay, so let's just put this all over. So this is like sun. Like I'm talking orange with gold shimmers. I see yellow. Super, super pretty. You just have to build. I've noticed that you have to kind of build this formula up. It's not super like boom in your face. It's cute. Okay, now this shade, I don't know how to, paradoxical, I don't know. I'm sorry guys, I don't know. Sorry my camera died, I don't know where it cut me off. But this shade right here, I'm telling you, this is the one that I was most excited about whenever I saw this palette. It was just like, almost like a glowing green, but like there's pink in there. Lots of different shifts, like you see how green it is? And then kind of like iridescent pink. I don't know, man. This shade really, like, I'm just really excited to try it. Okay, so this one's smooth. Kind of like the shade right here. This long snout shade. Be careful. I think that these might get dry paint. You have to be super careful. Make sure you don't get them wet. But yeah, I see green, gold, teal, pink. Super pretty. Okay, let's see how this baby applies. Very smooth. Common theme with this palette. This is going to be very flattering for those if you don't like I feel like some multi-chromes are super flaky in a way, especially like Give Me Glow, and they can really enhance your textured lids. But this formula, I've noticed, other than the shade Giraffe, it's very wearable, flattering. It's not gonna like show all your lines. So I don't know, I think that is going to be really exciting for a lot of people. But man, you really have to build them up. So if you like impactful multi-chromes, I don't know if this is going to be your girl. Okay, let me turn down the brightness. I love this super fiery shade right here. Now keep in mind, y'all are seeing it live. I'm just going in like 2, maybe 3 times building it up. I'm sure you could get these super bold if you go in and go in and go in. But like realistically, I don't do that. But I'm sure that other accounts and stuff, they're going to show you, like, these shades are really amped up. But I just want to give you kind of, like, a really just true impression. Just 1 to 2 swaps what the payoff is. But this green with this pink, it's really nice. It's just very subtle. Yeah, these are those two. And let's see. We have got 1, 2, 3 left. I have to add some more concealer real quick. I just also wanted to note at Swatches, but as of like right now, me filming, this is a very like true first impressions. I have not swatched these shades on my hand, arms, anything like that. So I just wanted you to know that this is a very true representation of like a first impressions going in blindly. Cause I wanted to show you my initial thoughts once I touched these shades. But girl, it was so difficult when this came in the mail. I just wanted to dive in. I was like, control yourself. You've got to take some pictures. You need to do a reel. But I just wanted to dive in. And then since I waited so long, I was like, you know what? This is definitely a good first impressions. Okay, I want to go in with this one next. Let's see. It's like, oh man, it's got all the different sparkles. Blue, pink, purple, some gold in there. Really, really pretty shade. And let's just see what you are about. Kind of looks more, I don't know, toned down like the rest. Oh, this one, the shift is a little bit more prominent with that green. I wasn't expecting. It's like glowing green. But like y'all see purple? Cool. Wow. I think that this shade right here is going to be a lot of people's favorites. Okay, now we're going to go with this pink, fiery orange shade. Oh, it's pink. You see that gold and orange? I'm telling you, this last row has my heart. Okay, so this one I like. It's more flaky, textured, so just keep that in mind. But yeah, we're gonna pop this. Oh yes, I love these like peachy pinks with the golds. Is it necessarily unique in a way? No, but I still love them. Okay, and let me just kind of smooth it out. And turn down the brightness. I really like how strong that shift is. Super sparkly. Really digging these two. So I'm going to wash this off. And then we have got one left to swatch. Okay, so I just added some more concealer, and I'm adding some bronzer. I got the new Charlotte Tilbury, not new, the re-release promoted palette. What is this? I don't even know if I can say the name of this. I'll just show you that palette, the new one. I'm loving it so much. Glowy, beautiful. Cannot get enough of this palette. Okay, so let's do the last shade. I've got a dog hair on me. Okay, it is a soft coral. Now, this shade looks honestly incredible. It's right here, and there's just so many different shifts I see. I see purple and pink and some teal. I don't know. I just cannot wait to see what this shade looks like. Why can I not find this dog hair? Every time I film, I can't find it. It tickles. I'm trying to get over it. Okay, this shade. Okay, I think this is going to be a lot of people's favorites too, just by like touching it. Really pretty. I like see purple and teal, and y'all are seeing pink. I love multi-chromes. They're so magical. I'm going to put this on both eyes since it's the last shade and smooth it out. I've noticed this one is a little bit textured, not as smooth as some of the rest, but I really do like that versatility within the palette to have different textures and stuff. But I love this shade right here. It's so pretty, right? Look at the sparkles. I love this shade so much. Anyways, I'm gonna zoom you out, kind of collect my thoughts, put some mascara on, and give you my first impressions on the Seahorse palette. Man, I literally just applied that Rare Beauty lip oil before I started filming, and my lips already are so dry. They look terrible. I don't know if I have a love-hate relationship with that. It's like I love it 1 minute and I hate it the next. I love the color. I just don't like the formula. It's drying my lips out bad. Like, I just applied it, I'm telling you, before I sat down and filmed it, this video. And my lips look absolutely terrible. But Unearthly Cosmetics is here to save the day. Okay, so let's talk about the Seahorse palette from Adept Cosmetics. Okay, so let's start off with the packaging. Are y'all kidding me? Like, I love the beach. I just love the aesthetic of the palette. I think it's so, so pretty. Love the packaging completely. And now let's talk about the color story. I think that this is very, very beautiful. It is more pastel, very toned down, more subtle multi-chromes, iridescent. Think of like beautiful gems, but like toned down. So I feel like with indie brands, we're so used to seeing like punchy, like in your face, like max pigmentation. This is not that. This, some of the shades are, but most of them are more subtle, very beautiful. I would say if you're like a neutral lover, and indie brands can be intimidating, honestly. Well, in my opinion, because sometimes the pigmentation is so, so much. And you were just looking for like wearable multi-chromes in a way, I think that you might like this one if you want more of like pastel multi-chromes. Now, let's talk about like the formula of this palette. There are a few shades, like you can kind of just see if they're more textured. Some of them that are a little bit of a thicker formula. But most of this palette, it's a new formula that I have seen. It's dry. It's some of them are smooth. So I'm not honestly obsessed with the formula, if I'm just being honest. Now if this was just with that being said, it's nice, but it's not my favorite that I've seen from Adept. I just wanted to note that. Still nice, it's just not what I was expecting, so I'm trying to like marinate on that. I'm like, oh snap, like this kind of threw me off. Anyways, now as far as like the price point goes, so like I said earlier, I paid, my hubby paid $113 for this. At that price point, like, if you're not obsessed with Adept, don't even, like, and then this palette's gonna retail for $140 before you use someone's code. That price, I just can't justify it. Now, if this palette was full of multi-chromes like House of L, the Heather Austin palette, the Minka palette, where it's just, like, intense pigmentation where you can just swatch it go down your arm. Y'all know, if you've tried Adept, if you have tried the House of L, some of those palettes, Ninhydrin, you already know what I'm talking about. So if that palette contained that formulation, like the squishy, wet formula I love from Adept, I would say yes. If you love Adept and you're looking for that, yes. Now, I would say if you are interested in this palette, proceed with caution because of the formula. It's nice, but just know it's different than what you're used to. I'm just being honest in my opinion. That's what I noticed about this palette. Still good, it's just different. Now, I know a lot of people, if you have FOMO because it's so pretty, just know that when I look at this, I don't see a shade that I'm like, oh wow, that is so unique, like you need this palette, you know? So there's nothing like super unique in a way where you can't find in your other palettes. If you have a huge singles collection, don't feel FOMO. But if you don't have any singles and you like pastel vibes, then I think you would like it. But anyways, that's kind of like my thoughts on this palette. I'm super happy I got it. I'm not in love with this formula just yet. Kind of, I think it's gonna have to grow on me. I have to get used to it just because it's not what I expected. But yeah, maybe also like the more you dig into them, you know, it just kind of gets better with time. But yeah, I love this palette. I'm super excited to have it in my collection. I'm very excited to play with it. I should have worn my seahorse necklace, but I forgot. Oh well. Anyways, hopefully I'm not forgetting anything. That's kind of my thoughts on this palette. Please let me know down below if you need to see any other shades. I can send them to you, do other stuff with it. I also received this palette. I purchased this palette. And I'm like, guys, what do you want me to do with this? It's huge. Let me know. Do you want to hear my thoughts? There's so many videos up already. I just kind of feel like, meh, I don't know. I got it for me. But I'm fine with filming if you want me to film some looks with this, because are you kidding me? This palette is so pretty. So I can't wait to dig into this. Let me know if you want me to do a look with it or what have you. But yeah, those are my thoughts on the Adept Seahorse palette. So pretty. Anyways, if you're still here, thank you so much for being here. But that's gonna do it for today's video. Wherever you are in the world, I hope you're doing well. I hope that you are healthy, happy, and safe. Stay beautiful. Bye guys.